Ecosystem Equilibrium, the reason the Yellowstone fires were left unsuppressed. In July of 1988, a wildfire was naturally ignited by lightning at Yellowstone National Park. Due to dry weather, the fire grew larger than expected, and nationwide manpower were mobilized to put out the fire. But the fire wasn't easily put out. After 2 months, 500,000 hectares of forest, one-third of the whole area, was burned by the fire. The fire was put out not by manpower, but by the first snowfall of the season. A lot of criticism was directed at the park caretakers, who let the fire burn and did not actively suppress the fire in its initial stages. However, they followed their wildfire protocols precisely. These protocols included the Let It Burn policy, which was established based on past firefighting experience. Even now, you can find evidence of the massive fire in Yellowstone National Park. There are still burnt trees in places. But the massive fire gave a new gift to Yellowstone Park. Aged trees that fed the fire burnt to ashes and fertilized the land. Not only that, but burnt areas were filled with new trees from sprouts that couldn't grow before due to the layer of centuries-old maple leaves. In the end, biological diversity increased. The ecosystem is very complex and delicate. Seemingly inconsequential creatures like insects or weeds have a role to play. Inorganic substances and organisms that form the ecosystem either eat each other, are eaten, or become nutrients to form a food chain. The structure of the food chain is like a complicated web with a serious impact if an entity disappears. Rapid environmental change, creating a chain of after effects for whatever reason, is called a trigger effect. The cause of such a change could be natural, as in the case of the Yellowstone fire, but it also happens through interference from mankind. In the early 1900s, people living on the Kaibab Plateau in Arizona started hunting pumas and wolves to prevent them from hunting deer, their main source of food. The number of deer increased rapidly with the absence of the predators, and people thought they had done well to protect the deer. But as the deer ate the plants and trees, the Kaibab Plateau was stripped bare, and more than half of the deer died within 20 years. The deer disappeared at a faster rate than in the days when the pumas and wolves hunted them. Mankind's rash interference destroyed the balance of the ecosystem. People learned that such interference with the ecosystem is dangerous. On the other hand, people also learned that when the balance in the ecosystem is broken, nature restores balance after enough time has passed. Even if the number of primary consumers temporarily increases or decreases the number of producers, breaking the balance, it is naturally restored as time goes on. Once the number of primary consumers increases, the number of secondary consumers increases as well, which causes the number of primary consumers to decrease. As the number of primary consumers decreases, the number of producers increases again, and as the number of secondary consumers decreases due to lack of food, the ecosystem is restored to balance. Nature has been maintaining its balance on its own for a long time. Humans should stop their conceited belief that they should control the ecosystem, but rather respect nature and live as a part of the ecosystem.